The next test that we're going to talk about is called comparison test, and the idea of this test is actually pretty simple. If we have two series, AN and BN, such that the term of the first guy, AN, is always less than or equal to BN, and these two guys are positive, so my AN, this is bigger than 0, then it should make sense that the sum of AN should be less than or equal to the sum of BN as well. So if my AN is less than or equal to BN, then the sum of AN should be less than or equal to the sum of BN. So then that means if the big guy, BN, converge, the small guy should also converge, which is what we have here. If B sub N converge, then A sub N should converge. On the other hand, if the small guy diverge, then the big guy, BN, should also diverge. So this is the idea of the comparison test. So the idea may not be that hard, but in practice, the hard part is going to be that we have to come up with another series to compare the original series with. For example, if I have my series here, 1 over 3 to the n plus 2, and I like to decide whether this guy converge or diverge. So now I would like to test this with something that we have known, and we should know already whether it converge or diverge. So we know its behavior already. So to begin, we should try something that looks similar to what we have here, 1 over 3 to the n plus 2. Well, so let's see. 1 over 3 to the n plus 2. Maybe if I get rid of the 2, then I'm gonna get 1 over 3 to the n. So now which guy is bigger? 1 over 3 to the n is bigger than or equal to 1 over 3 to the n plus 2. And so then this guy should be bigger than or equal to that guy. And we know this guy, this is a geometric series with the ratio 1/3. So this guy converge. So then I can now conclude that because the big guy converged, I can conclude that the smaller guy has to also converge. So I know this guy has to converge. Notice how the comparison test can tell whether a series converge or diverge, but I will not be able to tell its value. So for this guy, I can actually use the formula for the geometric series to compute its exact value, but I don't know the exact value for this guy. I only knew that it converged because even the big guy converged. So let's take a look at the next one. I have the series. I have the sum of log of n plus 1 over n. So again, the hard part of the comparison test is that I have to come up with something that looks like what we have here, and I can compare it with, and I should know whether that guy converged or diverged. So maybe I have, let's see, log of n plus 1 over n. I have two choices here. I can try log of n over n, or I can try 1 over n. And both of the new guy are going to be smaller than or equal to the original guy that we have here. Notice how we don't know whether the sum of log n over n is going to converge or diverge. So then that means this series that I bring up to compare with the original series, that means it doesn't work. So I can't really tell whether this guy is going to converge or diverge because I know nothing about this guy. But if we look at the other one now, because I know that the sum of 1 over n, this guy is actually a harmonic series. This is a P series when P equal to 1, and this guy diverged. And now, because the series that we have here is even bigger than this one, so I can conclude that this guy is going to diverge. So let's now take a look at the next one. I have 1 over square root of n plus 1, so maybe I can try 1 over square root of n. Now then, 1 over square root of n is going to be bigger than or equal to 1 over square root of n plus 1, and I can take a look at their sum. Now then, 1 over square root of n, this is actually a P series with P equal to 1/2. So this guy is going to diverge. So we have seen this in an example 3.9, by the way. So this guy is going to diverge. So the guy on the right-hand side diverged. So what can we conclude then? Well, the guy in the question is less than or equal to something that diverged. So I can't actually conclude anything from this relationship. Notice what we have earlier then. If we have the big guy, if we have that the big guy converge, then the smaller guy also has to converge. And if the smaller guy diverge, then the big guy has to diverge. But in this case, we have that the big guy diverge. Okay, so the big guy is very big, but then we can't really tell anything about the small guy though, because, well, this can be really big, or maybe it's just a number, because the right hand side, I can only tell that it is really big. So that means we actually can't really conclude anything from this relationship. When you have something like this, we might have to try other series to compare it with. Or you might have to try other tests. So in this lecture, we're going to be talking about many tests that we can use to tell whether a series converges or diverges. So one of the hard part then is going to be having to decide what test are we going to use. In this case, we will actually come back to this series later. So I'm just going to say we're going to come back in the next example, actually. So we're going to come back in 4.3. So let's do the next one. I have a series of log n over n squared. So let's try to compare this with, let me see, log n over n squared. Let's try to compare this with just 1 over n squared. How about this? Now then, log n over n squared is definitely bigger than or equal to 1 over n squared. So their sum also has to be bigger. And I knew that 1 over n squared, this guy is a P series with P equal to 2. So this guy converges. This guy converges. Now then, again, I can't really tell anything from this relationship because I know that the smaller guy converges. The smaller guy is just a number. But the big guy, I can't tell if this big guy is going to be a number or maybe it's very, very big. Maybe it's just the sum is going to be infinity. So I can't conclude anything from this relationship. So once again, whenever we see something like this, we might have to try other series. Or it could be the case that even if we try many other series, this test is not going to work. So we might have to try other tests. So once again, we're going to come back to this series later. So in fact, we'll come back in example 4.8. So for now, I'm just gonna leave these two examples be.